Hello, my beautiful people. Thank you all so much for clicking. This is your girl, Zilia Amy, once again. A mega shout out to all my returning subscribers. For those of you who are clicking for the first time, thank you so much for clicking. Please remember to subscribe at the end of this video. Click the notification bell and select all so you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video. The title today is, Can You Change Your Hair Porosity? Normally, if you have high or low porosity due to genetics, it's not possible to change your hair porosity. You can only look for ways or things to do that can help you better manage your hair, treat your hair, and how you can care for it to give you a healthier and stronger hair. So for those of you who are clicking for the first time, once again, if these terms are new to you, porosity, high porosity, low porosity, I would advise you watch the videos. Click to the links in the description box. It is also found in the comment section below. Click to those links and watch the video. That video is a detailed video on porosity, what porosity is all about, the different types of porosity, the characteristics of each type of porosity, and how to take the porosity test. Sorry guys, I have a co-host here and you can't stop her from talking. Please bear with me. So let's dive into the video. Now, how can you manage your hair based on your specific porosity? We are going to start with the low porosity hair type. With low porosity, if you want to select your deep conditioner, make sure that you select a conditioner which is proton free. Okay, select a conditioner which is proton free because such conditioners easily penetrate your hair cuticles. Okay, they easily penetrate your hair cuticles and they are less likely to have products build up. Secondly, for low porosity, before you deep condition your hair, make sure that your hair is wet. That is because when your hair is wet, it's going to dilute the conditioner and that will help the conditioner to easily penetrate your hair. Thirdly, if you're going for your shampoo, you want to select your shampoo, make sure that you select a shampoo which contains honey and glycerin. And also make sure that the ingredients in your shampoo, it does not have oils because oils are harder to penetrate your hair. Okay. Thirdly, when applying the conditioners, after applying the deep conditioner to your hair, make sure that you add heat to it, okay? You can either wear a steamer, you can wear a hoodie, or you wear a hoodie dryer, or you wear a heat cap. That is because it's going to help to steam your hair and help the conditioner to easily penetrate into your hair. If you don't have any of this, you can use a plastic like I always do in my video, like you tie a plastic on your hair after applying the deep conditioner. Then you can add a shower cap and a hair scarf to give it that heat, like to help steam your hair. That way the conditioner is going to penetrate your hair easily and properly. So that is it with low porosity, okay? Just try to make sure that you always check the ingredients before you, the ingredients in your conditioners, the ingredients in your shampoos before you use them. That will help you best, like it's going to help you to have the best results for your specific hair porosity. Okay, now with high porosity, you know these terms already. Like I said, if you're clicking for the first time and these terms are somehow new to you, make sure that you watch the videos with the links in the description box and in the comment section, because you're going to understand these things very well. If you just dive into this video without watching those ones, you'll find it difficult to understand what I'm talking about. The next one is high porosity. High porosity, firstly, before you select your shampoo, make sure that you look for ingredients like butter and oils in your shampoo, that is because they are going to help moisturize your hair very well. Secondly, you should always go in for leave-in conditioners and sealers, because these are also going to help your hair retain moisture and stay healthy for a very long time. Thirdly, when you're washing off your shampoos or your conditioners, make sure that you stay away from hot water. Okay, stay away from hot water. Go for lukewarm water if you don't want to use cold water. Fourthly, after shampooing your hair and deep conditioning your hair, if you feel that you want to style your hair with a heat styling tool, make sure that you apply heat protecting cream on your hair, so that is going to protect your hair from damage and dryness. Okay, and the fourth point is, always when you're selecting your shampoo, do well also to check sulfate free shampoos. This is because sulfate free shampoos don't leave your hair dry, unlike shampoos with sulfate. They're going to leave your hair very dry after washing, and your hair porosity type does not need anything that will cause you dryness after washing your hair. Okay, so you go in for sulfate free shampoos. Generally speaking, if these terms are new to you, like I said earlier, do well to visit my previous video. The videos in the description box and in the comment section. Those videos give a detailed definition of most of the terms we've used here. Okay, this is because hair porosity is something that people hardly talk about, but understanding your hair porosity is one of the greatest steps of having a good understanding of your hair. Because if you understand your hair porosity, you select the right product based on your hair porosity, your hair is going to remain healthy, it is going to be strong, and you are going to enjoy your hair. And one misconception a lot of people have is those people who take care of their hair a lot are people who are living long hair. But that is not right, because everyone needs to take care of their hair, be it long or short hair, because even short hair looks does if short hair does not look healthy, it won't look good on you. Okay, so whether you have short hair or long hair, it's good to understand your hair porosity. It's good to know the kind of products to use on your hair. It's good to know the kind of ingredients that are right based on your hair porosity. Don't just go for products because you watched on YouTube or you saw a product that everyone is using and you go for that one, thinking that, okay, you have short hair, it won't affect your hair. The necessary thing for your hair is to always look shiny, to always look moisturized, and that will automatically give it beauty. And if your hair is dry, frizzy, and doesn't look healthy, it won't make you beautiful. And remember, our hair is our crown, and we don't have to like wear wigs always and braids. Sometimes it is good to flaunt our crown and carry it with all the pride. Okay, so try to understand these terms, use the right ingredients, and you are going to be proud of your hair. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this video is helpful to you. If you find it interesting, please leave a comment in the comment section below. And if there is anything that you want me to talk about related to hair or skin, you can also drop your questions there in the comment section below, and I'm going to do a video on that. Thank you so much. Please do well to share this video, and don't forget to show me some love by leaving a thumbs up. Love you guys so much. Bye bye.